今日はね、もうギターの神様スティーブ・バインに来てもらってますよ。 Welcome to Japan.
Thank you. It's nice to be here.
It's very... It's an honor to meet you.
Well, thank you.
As like a guitar god over here. And how do you like Japan?
I love Japan. I cherish the time that I get to come here. It's a wonderful city. It's thriving. Big Mecca. And people, very low crime, and the people are very nice.
I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah, it's great.
So, how many times have you been to Japan? Quite a lot.
Yeah, I've been coming since 1984. Mm-hmm. And, you know, maybe a dozen times or so. But every time I come, it gets better and better, so.
I'm glad to hear that, too. And tell us your concept for your new album, The Virtual Zone.
I wanted to make a record that was a culmination of everything that I've done in the past and everything that I feel about music now. And it's got, you know, guitar playing. It's got some crazy guitar playing. It has some very emotional, you know, I tried to be as emotional as I could on this record when I was writing the songs and playing the guitar. Because, you know, at this point, what else am I going to do? I mean, I'm not like a pop star, you know, so I want to be extremely intense about the music, you know. So the Ultra Zone is really, it has elements of composition, you know, and it has some very accessible type, you know, pop music, but stuff that I like, stuff that I think is good. I'm very happy with it. I'm very happy. It's come a long time for me to be able to say that I really love my own music.
And I heard that last night you had a show for the first show for the new album.
Well, it wasn't really a show. It was I played to a little studio audience of people, and I played to a DAT machine. But it was the first time that I performed any music from the Ultra Zone, and it was kind of fun. I have this one song. I have this wacky guitar with three necks on it.
Wow.
You know, it's got like a 12-string here, and it's got a neck over here, and I wrote this song. And I didn't know if I was coming or coming.
And I remember that you used to play a guitar like an X shape or like a heart shape.
Well, that's the guitar.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I wrote a song called Fever Dream with that guitar. Except now it's a purple guitar.
It's purple.
Yeah, it's a purple heart. Yeah, I was a little tired of getting on stage with a big red heart on.
Is that an Ibanez guitar?
Yes, yes. Ibanez is the guitar company that I've been working with for years now. Many years, I think 13 years. For me, they're just, you know, they're just the ultimate. They make great guitars, quality instruments, and also they're willing to make a wacky guitar with three, you know, three necks and a heart.
I used to have I still have an Ibanez guitar.
Was it shaped like a heart?
No.
You'll have to leave now.
What do you think? What do you think about the recent music scene for as a guitarist?
Well, you know, I think that young kids are focusing on the guitar in a very different way than like myself. I spent many, many hours as a child growing up playing the guitar, and I create a certain kind of music because of that. Today, they have a different focus on the instrument. You know, people hear what I do, and they hear what, you know, some like Yngwie or Joe Satriani, and they just think, ah, you know, wow, I don't want to practice that much, you know. But they do other interesting things with the guitar. I mean, the guitar is still a very prominent instrument in rock music. It will always be. How could it not? It's just, you know, the sound of the guitar fills you up. You know, whether it's clean, twangy country music or if it's, you know, corn, you know, it just fills you up. So I think that there's people doing interesting things, and I don't see anybody really trying to cultivate the instrument in a new direction as far as virtuosity. You know what I'm saying? But still, it doesn't mean, you know, you don't have to be an incredible guitar player to do incredible things on the guitar or to make incredible music.
Speaking of Korn and Limp Bizkit and all other guitar players that admire you, and I think that they use the Ibanez guitar.
Yeah.
And what do you think about this?
I think it's fantastic. You know, when I designed the 7-string for Ibanez, I really designed it not just for myself in mind, but I just knew that there'd be people who would come along and do other things with that instrument. And there's some great jazz players out there that are using the 7-string guitar. And when I heard Korn, I mean, you know, my heart went pitter-patter, because, man, they really make use of that instrument. And like bands like, you know, Limp Bizkit, and, you know, that new wave of heavy metal guitar playing, it's the 7-string is just a ripe instrument for it. And I just love hearing what they're doing with it. That's what I mean about, you know, there's kids are still being innovative on the instrument, even though they're not going.
I also read in an article that in your interview that you used to make, you made this guitar with 16 or 18 frets in
octave. Yeah.
Do you see what is that?
Well, you can't really. I mean, it's what I did with, took, you know, an octave. In tempered music, contemporary tempered music is divided into 12 steps. And it's what we're aware, you know, it's what our ears are used to for the past centuries. Well, I took that 12 steps and made it 16. So all the steps are different.
It's all different.
Very different. Wow, it's really weird. And I recorded some music with it. One piece made it to the Sex and Religion record. But it's not the kind of music that, you know, I think people are ready to listen to. You know, it's perfect music to destroy my career, actually. But it's interesting. It pulls on your ear very differently. I'd like to incorporate more of it into some of the stuff I'm doing, but it's difficult. Difficult to play. We'll be right back.
now at this time?
A rival.
Rival. Somebody else who you see as a rival.
Jesus Christ.
Wow.
No, I'm kidding. It's a joke. I'm not John Lennon. A rival. Well, there are people who do some, you know, things, you mean musically? There are people who do things that I'm very impressed with and I find inspiration from. But I never, you know, whenever I feel like a tinge of, say, envy or jealousy, I stamp it out immediately and I try to become more of a student, you know?
So nobody like a rival, or maybe he's better than me, so it's like not like a race.
Well, it's not like sports. You know, like if I listen to, I don't know, name a guitar player who you think would be a rival.
For me, like, a guitar guy is like Steve Vai, and like you said, Joe Satriani, and those people are like...
Joe Satriani and I grew up together. He was my guitar teacher. I've always had the absolute utmost respect for him. You know, if Joe plays one note, I love it. You know, I mean, people think that we're rivals, but how can I rival with him? You know, what are we competing with? I mean, he inspires me. You know, he lights up my life, you know, because of his inspiration. You know, he has been, like a lot of guitar players, Jimmy Page, you know, Ritchie Blackmore, even Yngwie, or, you know, Michael Hedges. These people are more like elements of what they do I want to aspire to. You know, harboring feelings of envy, it's just not healthy, you know? Do I want to sell as many records as Jimmy Page? Oh, I'd love to, you know, but I can't count on that. You know, Jimi Hendrix. You know.
So it's more of respecting each other.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I compete with myself, you know? If I am gonna learn something on the instrument, I'm not gonna try to learn it because somebody else can do it better. You know, I compete with myself. I mean, I listen to my music and it fills me up. You know, I sit in sometimes, and I mean this, you know, humbly, but I sit in astonishment sometimes when I listen to my music and I think, how did I do that? You know, there's songs on my record. Well, I guess I would say there's songs on my record, like a song like Ooh. If I heard anybody else do that, I would fall over dead. then I'd probably be really jealous. And I'd have to find that person and kill them.
And any plans for playing a show again in Japan?
Oh, yes. I hope to come back in January or February and blow up the bridge.
Let's just hope the world is still here. And if you have some message for the fans, please.
It's very great to be able to come and play, and I hope to bring great entertainment to anybody who enjoys the kind of music that I do. Wear sunscreen and use a condom.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.
Steve Vai's on this time.